Hey, what is up, everybody? This is the great Puckettini coming at you on behalf of PuckettFanshop.com. And over at PuckettFanshop.com, that's my website where we make dog designs. We put them on all kinds of products, from t-shirts, stickers, socks, aprons, just all kinds of things you can think of. Hoodies, stickers are our best seller right now. But anyway, we'll put them on anything. So head over to Puckett Fan Shop and check all our designs out. And if there's one that you like, I'd love to do business with you. If there's one we don't have, like a certain dog breed you like and we don't have, just send me a message and I'd love to put it on there and do business with you. Our newest one is the Rhodesian Ridgeway, I think is the name of it. I can't remember. But it's a beautiful dog, and you'll be seeing those pretty soon. I'm not too familiar with them. But it was a customer asked us about it, and so we're going to make it. But anyway, what I've got for you today is the top 10 Arkansas Razorback highlights versus Missouri State, the football game that played last Saturday. So, and these are the top 10 highlights. And they're not really necessarily in any order. I just have 10 highlights, and there could have been more. I know a lot of people think that it was kind of a win that wasn't too great or whatever, but hey, a win is a win, I'm telling you. And Missouri State's a good football team. It's kind of like when Arkansas basketball team a year or two ago when Eric Musselman played that non-conference schedule and everybody thought it was weak, and it turned out to be really strong. And most of those teams they played ended up in the NCAA tournament, and it turned out to be really strong. And I think that's the way Missouri State's going to be. They're going to turn out to be really good thing with not get injured. You know, and things like that. All right, so here we go. Number one, key highlight, top 10 highlight, number one versus Missouri State, Arkansas Razorbacks versus Missouri State, is sophomore running back Rocket Raheem Sanders from Rockledge, Florida. He rushed for 171 yards on 22 carries and two total touchdowns. He had one rushing, one receiving. He averaged a whopping 7.6 yards per carry. And he just took over the second half, I thought. I thought they should have ran him even more. He had 22 carries, but I thought they should have ran him more in the first half. And all I can say, guys, is Rocket Sanders for the Heisman. I mean, he's got to be on the watch list. He's got to be I don't know anybody's had as good of a start to year as him. But clearly he's got to keep going doing good. But so far he's burning it up. So great job by Rocket. Number two highlight was redshirt junior quarterback KJ Jefferson from Sardis, Mississippi. He rushed 9 times for 41 yards and had one rushing touchdown. He also completed 19 passes for 385 yards and two touchdowns. So had a great game through the air. He accounted for 426 yards of total offense. That is a bunch, 426 total yards. It's almost halfway to 1,000. highlight number three is Arkansas's offensive line. These guys played a great game. We rushed for 220 yards and two touchdowns. We passed for 385 yards and two touchdowns. So our total offensive yards versus Missouri State was 605 yards and four touchdowns. And oh, by the way, they gave up no sacks. And that was 385 yards passing. There were no sacks. So the starting offensive line, the best I could tell, was redshirt senior left tackle Luke Jones from Little Rock, Arkansas. Redshirt junior left guard Brady Latham from Jinx, Oklahoma. Senior center Ricky Stromberg from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Redshirt junior right guard Bo Limmer from Tyler, Texas. I think he's really been playing well. And then redshirt senior right tackle, the big man Dalton Wagner from Spring Grove, Illinois. Those guys paved the way, gave up no sacks, 7.6 yards per carry, just had a great game once again. I mean, those guys are really being road graders for us and doing a great job this year. All right, highlight number four is redshirt junior wide receiver Jadon Hazelwood from Atlanta, Georgia. Jadon was second in catches Saturday with 5 for 86 yards and one touchdown, so he had a really good game. And then number five, like I said, this is not in really any order because this guy would probably have been first, was his junior linebacker, Drew Sanders from Denton, Texas, transferred from Alabama. This young man is, if Rocket's up for the Heisman, this guy should be up for the Linebacker of the Year Award, Defensive Player of the Year Award. I forget all the names for those. But anyway, he had another monster game, this young man. He led the team with 12 tackles that were 5 solo tackles and 7 assists. He had 2.5 sacks. I mean, this guy is like a machine out there. They couldn't block him. He had 2.5 tackles for loss. He had 1 pass broken up, which means he was in coverage and broke up a pass. And he had the biggest hit of the night, if not of the year. It was in the third quarter. The score was tied at 17-all, 17 apiece. Missouri State had the ball at the Arkansas 48. They crossed the 50, looking like, and it was a 3rd and 1. It looked like they were going to go score again, and somebody had to step up and make a big play and stop the drive. And in came Drew Sanders, and he unleashed. I mean, holy moly, he laid the wood to Jacardia Wright, who is a heck of a running back, their number one running back. I mean, he pounded him. If you haven't seen it, go to YouTube and type in Drew Sanders' big hit, and you can see it. It is unreal. Wow, and that really energized Arkansas. I mean, if they'd got that first down there, we really would have been in trouble. And like you say, you just big players make big plays in big games, and Drew did that. Holy moly, that was unreal. Great play by Drew Sanders. All right, number six is that we had 5 players that sacked Jason Shelley, the Missouri State's quarterback. We had a hard time with him. He was good, but he's a good player. Transferred in from Utah State. Heck of a quarterback. Okay, the 6 players were Drew Sanders, had 2.5 sacks. Already said that. Redshirt senior defensive end Jordan Dominick is showing he's a very good pass rusher. He's from Florida, from Lakeland, Florida. He had 2 sacks as well. Senior defensive end Zach Williams from Little Rock, Arkansas, had 2 sacks as well. Sophomore defensive lineman Landon Jackson from Texarkana, Texas, right down the road from me. He had 1 sack. He's from Pleasant Grove High School. Sophomore defensive back Jaden Johnson's from Cedartown, Georgia. He had 0.5 sack. That young man's really coming on and playing and doing some great things as a sophomore. I mean, he's had to been thrust into playing time because of injuries, and he has really come on and played well. He should really be proud of himself, Jaden Johnson. All right, number 7. Redshirt freshman wide receiver Bryce Stevens from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Boy, oh boy. I've been waiting on him to bust a big one. He's been close several times. I keep telling myself he's going to hit one big, and he sure did Saturday night. He had 3 punt returns for 105 yards and 1 touchdown. And then his big one came in the 4th quarter. Arkansas was down 27-24, 4th quarter, 9:34 left in the game. And that right there, he returned it. It was maybe 60, 70 yards. I did not write down the yardage on that, so I cannot remember off the top of my head, but it was unreal. I was jumping up and down, I know, in my house when he broke, and I've been waiting on him to do it. He's been so close several times, and he finally got it. And great job, Bryce Stevens, man. That was a heck of a play. It was very much needed. Boy, that play and Drew Sanders' big hit and then Rocket's big screen or that shovel pass. Oh, those 3 plays there were huge. All right, so Bryce Stevens, great job there. He's turned into a really good punt returner. Number 8, highlight. Senior wide receiver Matt Landers from St. Petersburg, Florida. He transferred from Toledo. He also played at Georgia, I think, when Sam Pittman was there. He led the team with 7 catches for 123 yards. Had a great game. Showed what he can do, what we've been hearing about. You know, big, fast. I just wish he would have broke a big one and got in the end zone. He had a good game, 7 for 123. Good job at Matt Landers. Highlight number 9 is senior kicker Jake Bates from Tomball, Texas. You know, he had 7 kickoffs, and 6 of those kickoffs went for touchbacks. And that's really huge. You know, you got a great offense like Missouri State and Bobby Petrino running it. You got to put everything, you got to make everything hard on them. And hitting those touchbacks like that are huge. Making them drive the very farthest you can, that is so big and so important. Great job by Jake Bates there. That's just a great job. I know I heard Coach Pittman saying last year they gave up a scholarship to, I can't remember his name. I'm getting old, I guess. and they gave a scholarship to the kicker last year. It wasn't Cam Little. He's a field goal kicker. The other guy, I can't remember the guy's name. I'm sorry. And gave him a scholarship just because he could kick it out of the back of the end zone and make every team start, you know, from the, I think it's the 25. Is that right? They've changed that so many times. I can't remember. But making them drive the very most, the farthest you can make them drive from is huge, huge, huge. All right, number 10 highlight, and this is not, like I said, in any order, but redshirt senior safety, Simeon Blair from Pine Bluff, Arkansas. They were trying to pick on him a lot, I think. Petrino was trying to throw their third receiver locked up on Simeon a lot, or one of their younger corners. But Simeon played well. He was second on the team in tackles with 10. He had 9 solo tackles and 1 assist. He also had 1 pass breakup. And I tell you, the tackles he made, if he didn't make them, it was going to be a big play for a touchdown. He was locked in man-to-man a lot in the slot, I saw. And he and they were picking on him. You know, safeties aren't used to covering receivers like that, but because Arkansas has had so many injuries, Slusher's our main nickelback, and he's out. So, you know, he was probably the best at that. And they were trying to pick on him a lot. And he's playing out of position doing that. But he did a very good job. And second on the team tackles, 9 solo tackles. That's a bunch. But so great job by Simeon there too. So that's all I got. It was a big win for the Razorbacks. I don't want to hear none of that mess about their upset about that win. Hogwash. That's a very good Missouri State team. I don't care what level they're on. You know, I said in an earlier video that 21 transfers from Division I schools. Their best 3 players all come from Division I. Their big receiver, he came from Central Michigan. Running back came from Jacardi Wright, came from I can't remember now. But then Jason Shelley came from Utah State. So they all come from Division I schools, and it's not like it used to be. These guys can play Division I. They just went somewhere kind of like Drew Sanders has done, where they could play right away. Like Drew Sanders, is he a player? Yeah. You know, and trust me, Coach Petrino knows good players. He knows, you know, remember he had us, Arkansas, at number 5 in the country. Pittman knows good players too. Don't get me wrong. Anyway, if you like this video, please hit the like and share button and head over to Puckett Fan Shop, PucketFanShop.com, and check out my dog designs. And I'd love to do business with you. And I'm going to be making I do videos on Arkansas and Dallas, the Dallas Cowboys. And so come back to the Great Puckettini channel and check out more of my videos. We'll see you guys later. Go Hogs. Get an Aggie.